The views and opinions expressed in this program are those of the participants and do not necessarily reflect the views of BronxNet or the program underwriters.
I've been doing this now for 34 years. everybody feeling? Oh my God, thank you so much for coming in the rain. I was so scared in the car. I was like, my God, by the time I get there, they're gonna be gone. But you see, the people from the Bronx are different. The people from the Bronx, they feel like as long as you give me good music, I'll go anywhere you want me to go. So I love coming here to Orchard Beach. I haven't been here in a while. This was the beach that I went to when I was a little kid growing up. I always went to Section 8. That's my favorite. But I loved eating the warm ham and cheese sandwiches with the sand in it. And I swear to God, growing up, I thought Orchard Beach was the only beach in the country. That's how much I adore Orchard Beach. But I want you to know that every single bit of success that I have to this day is because I grew up right here in the Boogie Down Bronx. You guys want some more freestyle?
And now for my next number, I'd like to return to the classics. Perhaps the most famous classic in all the world of music.
Okay, good. All right, good. So let me explain to you why we love freestyle music so much. In addition to the fact that it was born in the Bronx, freestyle is like an English telenovela. There was a lot of drama, all right? So once upon a time, this woman was walking. She was like, I'll be all you ever need, satisfaction guaranteed. If you give me half a chance, I'll be your girl. So as soon as he saw her, he was like, oh, my fantasy girl, you're my fantasy girl, I need you tonight. But she knew she couldn't give it away right away, because ladies, we don't do that, right? Because we want men to treat us like a priority, not like an option. So she said, show me you really love me. And instantly he's like, okay, I have to seduce her. And the only way to seduce a woman in freestyle is with a George Lamont song. Without you, I don't know what I'll do without you, girl. was so good that they hooked up to the only dirty freestyle song we have. Ooh, oh, diamond girl, yes, yes, you're my diamond girl. And everything was great for like 3 days. And then one night he called her at 3 o'clock in the morning, booty call time, and he left her a message, boop. Where are you tonight, my love, in the arms of another man? Where do I belong in your heart? Can it be that I'm going mad? Well, she didn't appreciate that. So the next morning she woke up and she started to text him. I'm writing this letter to let you know this love of ours just can't go. I never knew how happy I would be till you showed me how love can be. This letter is to let you know. Thank you so much. Okay. So you want another song? I'm going to dedicate this to you guys because I wouldn't have nothing, none of this success at all if it wasn't for you guys. And this song was based on a man who broke my heart when I was 19 years old. Yep. And even though I never saw him again, and people think I tell this story because I'm not over him, but I'm over him because I don't care that his name is Pablo Santana. He's 6'3". They saw him last in Orlando, Florida, and the last 4 digits of his social is 4321. They don't care about that. My mother, and mothers are always right, my mother said to me, Mommy, take the bad thing that happened to you and put it into your music and watch how God is going to reward you. So I said, okay. So I took this horrible experience, even though I never saw him again. Wait. Ese hombre que tú ves allí, que parece tan galante, tan atento y arrogante, lo conozco como a mí. Nah, I'm kidding, I'm kidding. He looked a little bit like him, I'm just saying. But anyway, even though I never saw him again, I did use that bad memory, and I put in the lyrics of this song, and it has been paying all my bills for the last 34 years.
You've always been by my side. chubby waist, thick legs in shape, rump shaking, both legs make you do a double take.
Thank you.